Hi, I'm John Williams. I'm here today with Nadine Horn. Hello, Nadine.
Hello, John.
This is the first of our series of videos for a 30-day challenge called Challenge TV. And we're going to be doing a series of interviews with interesting people who've started something amazing, perhaps a business or a project or a book, and pick up what they've learned about making things happen, about finding ideas, about getting over obstacles, so that we can send one of these out every week on the 30-day challenge itself, and all the participants can watch it and get inspired and learn something about how you make stuff happen. So this is a bit of a special one because you've actually done the 30-day challenge, Nadine.
Like,
when was it? A couple of years ago, right?
I think it was 2 years ago, yeah.
And when you went in, you've done amazing things, but when you went into the challenge, you actually didn't have an idea. You didn't know what you were going to do, did you?
No. I was stuck.
Yeah. And you came up with this idea to... Well, tell me what it was.
To create an adventure and get paid for it.
But it's like the challenge is like, how do you become an adventurer? There's no career path for that, is there? No one says, there's no tick box when you're at school on how to become an adventurer. So you thought, well, I'll just go and create an adventure and go do it, which was Mission Spain. So do you want to tell us what you did?
Yeah, so I had really no idea where to start off with. And I realized before, maybe an adventure for me is like learning something new, exploring a new country. Yeah. And having a physical challenge. So I thought I'm gonna pick anything. So I picked Spain, never been to Spain. I picked learning Spanish because I couldn't speak a word Spanish. And I have never most probably cycled more than 80 kilometers.
No, really?
And this was 4,000 kilometers. So I just, the Google map, and I just draw like a circle without a plan. It's like, okay, I'm gonna cycle around, I'm gonna learn fluent Spanish on the way.
And by the 30th day of a 30-day challenge, you come up with this idea. I mean, you made it happen, right?
I did. Day 28. Yeah. I had the sponsorship for a bike. I had a sponsorship for 2 weeks language course.
Yeah.
Someone paid my cab to go to the airport.
So on the 30th day, was it, or 28th day, you were on a train, basically?
On the actually 31st day, so just 2-3 days after, but everything was set in stone. I had a blog, I never had a blog before, had all the equipment ready, I was ready.
Wow, and someone paid for your bike, paid for your language course, and you did it, you cycled the whole 4,000 kilometres?
2 months and 4,000 kilometres. And fluent Spanish. I was starting writing the blog just in English first, but I also said, after the language course, I'm not going to speak English, just really to make the mission of. And after a couple of weeks, I started to write in English and Spanish. And then I completely wrote my blog posts in Spanish.
Wow. That's impressive. So what was it? You credit, it's amazing stuff, and all credit to you. But you said that the challenge really seemed to be the key that unlocked all this for you. What was it that happened in the 30-day challenge that made such a difference?
I think it was the belief from the outside that you can do it.
Yeah.
But also having a community, rather than getting paralyzed when you get stuck on this one thing. And because you just have 30 days and you want to produce something, you actually ask the people in the community.
Yeah.
And because they have created something, and you know what you have created in the book and different people at this point, you know it's possible.
Yeah.
So you blur it out, and in the evening I would lock in, I had an answer to my problem.
Yeah.
Then off you go again.
So, and you came back and did another challenge in order to do a different project.
Yes.
So, and that's this book. Tell us the name of the book.
It's called Don't Just Talk, Do It and Make Your Crazy Idea Happen.
Said in your best German accent, which should explain your German.
Did I do it in my German accent?
German English. Don't just talk, do it.
And make your crazy idea happen.
Yeah. And you wrote that and published it in 30 days.
Yes, I did.
On the 30-day challenge.
Because when I got
back... Oh, it's got cartoons.
Yes. So a friend of mine, because it shows from where I started having no idea at all to really doing it. So it's
nicely laid out as well, actually.
Seven steps of how it worked.
Might well have been. So that's amazing. So you got that out as well. But how did you make time? Because you said you were using... We teach this thing called microblocking on the 30-day challenge.
Mm.
But how to make use of really small blocks of time.
Yeah.
And you use that trick for writing the book, didn't you?
So I said, I want to have fun while I do it. So every morning I would go in a pub or like in a cafe where it was in a nice environment.
Yeah.
And then 20 minutes, just put 20 minutes down. What am I going to produce in the next 20 minutes?
Yeah.
And then, okay, 20 minutes, I'm just going to blur. Okay. Mm. And then I could let go and go off the day. But then you get ideas. It's like, oh, I'm going to do another 20 minutes. I'm going to do this. I was amazed. I never thought about it. Can write a book.
I think it's brilliant. And did you put this up? Is this on Amazon or is this from your own site?
So it's self-published on Lulu.
Okay.
I'm going to relaunch it, but you can get it from my site.
So if I go to people watching want to get this, you can go to NadineHorn.com.
Exactly, NadineHorn.com.
H-O-R-N.
Exactly.
And check out the book. But so now you're doing a whole selection of interesting things, and I think it's you're assembling a career. And you know, it's still a work in progress, you're assembling a career where you're already getting paid to do some of the things you love doing. And it's a whole mixture of stuff. And the reason why we're both sitting here barefoot is partly, not just because it's really hot today, but because this is part of what you do. So you help people to go back to walking, running, and whatever else, and standing barefoot, because you're a big believer in this. Can you explain a bit about it?
Yeah, it's a really funny thing. So my second adventure, once I did Mission Spain, I wanted to train for a triathlon, never did a triathlon.
Mm.
And I signed up for a half Ironman and I thought I need something motivating to do it. So again, I picked the three things. So I decided I'm going to do a triathlon across three countries.
Mm.
Cycle across Switzerland, but now I could cycle. Swim 200 kilometers the Danube. I never swam more than 2 kilometers. And I ran across Austria.
Wow, I assumed you were a really super marathon kind of person before you did this.
No. Wow. I had never done it, but the motivation was the next morning, I don't know where am I going to be, I need some food, I'm going to meet amazing people, am I going to see an amazing landscape? You take off the whole pressure of like doing this.
Yeah.
And then everything went fine. I only got injured when I ran across Austria.
Yeah.
I had like a knee problem, an Achilles, and I thought I was a good runner.
Okay, yeah.
And then I had a talk at the Outdoor Expo, which was an absolute pleasure.
Mm.
And I came across Lee Saxby, the biomechanics of running as a skill. And I thought, really? Because I got injured, I was curious.
Mm.
And then I got coached by him, and then understanding how we're actually using the foot.
Yeah.
And the whole, how the human body is kind of designed. And through this, it's just another door open to become more efficient. And then I got the chance to actually help people, and they all work like together with physios when they have clients and they don't know what they're going to do, like I work on their feet or I change the technique, and it's really powerful, and doing workshops and everything, and it's amazing.
So you're going to experiment with me a little bit. We're going to go outside and you're going to check out my posture and how natural I can stand and walk, and
actually a little bit of toe yoga
which sounds very exciting.
Be a boxer in the golden ring. Can you punch like a southbound freight train? Tell me just one thing. Can you move anywhere like a hummingbird's wing if you need to?
Ooh, that's fast.
Can you bob, can you weave, can you fake and see when you need to? Well, you might as well quit if you haven't got it.
Put him in the ring, Joe, look at what you found. We can use the punch, Joe, pushing him around.
So Nadine, it's been great finding out everything you've got out of the 30-day challenge and everything you've done since. But what would you say to someone who's considering doing it right now?
Do it. It changed my life and it still does. It's just reminding and knowing, if I could do that, I can do the other thing. So you're stepping up levels.
Yeah.
But it's a reminder, if I can do that, I can do that. You're getting more confident.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Thank you, Nadine.
You're welcome.